We're on a bus right now. We're leaving Davao and we're going to
Cagayan de Oro.
Very good. Awesome. I can't remember how to say any town names. So we're going there and it's supposed to be quite a long trip. I think it's almost all the way across the island from the southern area to the northern area. And it's going to take us like 7 or 8 hours or something. And we opted for the non-air-conditioned cheap bus because one, it's cheaper, and two, we're not going to die of the Arctic wind instead of the air-conditioned bus, so it might actually be more comfortable.
I'd almost rather be sitting on this bus with the breeze and the mountains than sitting on any beach. So we stopped for about like 15 or 20 minutes on the side of the road. There were tons and tons of like little snack shacks, and there was really only like one eatery that had meat or vegetables or anything more than just snacks or pastries like what I have. They also had a bathroom, which was very difficult to use with a backpack on, but I made the best of it and went to the bathroom. It turns out that the toilet seat not being on the toilet is pretty much universal here. I don't know how the girls are using the bathroom. Like, it says comfort room, but I'm not comforted by no toilet seat. I don't know if they're sitting on it or if they're just hovering, but I'm hovering, for sure. That's not cool. So, that was the bathroom experience, and it cost 5 pesos to use the bathroom. Do you know how much that is?
Nothing.
I think it's like 12 cents.
Yeah.
Maybe. Terrible. I don't know. When it gets low like that, it's really hard to do the math. But it's quite cheap to use the bathroom. No toilet paper, and they usually don't flush. You have to pour water into the toilet to make it flush. Outside of the bathroom, they had all the food and stuff. I ended up getting like a vegetable medley kind of thing that had non-sweet melon and carrots that had just been stewed in a really kind of a little bit of a garlic sauce, and that was quite good. I also got 2 boiled eggs, and that cost 36 pesos. So it was 1/6 of the price to use it. That's an eagle. Oh my gosh. Sorry. That cost about 5 times as much as the toilet. That seems about equivalent. And from one of the snack shacks, I also bought these little cakes. And I think they're ube, like what we had in the ice cream yesterday, with some coconut. And I also don't know what's on the inside. Nadu. And nothing inside, just coconut with ube. I should probably try one.
Why are you distracted?
There's a guy that's standing very close, and he's just kind of been begging the entire time we've been on the bus, and he's okay with getting very close, and I'm gonna eat it, and it's gonna be really awkward.
Somebody translate what they're saying for us, please.
It tastes like cookie dough that hasn't been cooked yet.
That's good.
Yeah, it's really, really good.
Is it ube?
It just tastes like cookie. I don't really get like a flavor feel. Like chocolate chip cookies is what I feel like I just put in my mouth.
And coconut?
Yeah, the coconut's kind of an afterthought. It's just a crunch on the outside.
Ah.
Yeah.
I think this one's finished.
I think it's finished.
This is awkward. Sorry about the awkward end of that video, but like this guy was like, inches very, very close to my head, like with his hand out, basically begging. And he's extremely overweight, which makes me think, like, why are you asking me for food? Like, you have food access someplace. I don't know, is that rude to say? I don't know. But anyway, it was really kind of an awkward moment for us. Not sure why, but we stopped like 5 minutes after the last stop again, and this time where we stopped, we were there for like 5 minutes, and Katie got a pomelo. And this is something that we have only had a little bit of in the past, so we're going to try a whole bunch of one and see what it's up.
So it looks like this, and the outside, the texture is like a grapefruit, but it's way, way bigger than a grapefruit. Like this is probably twice the size of what you get for a grapefruit. The flavor
Really? Twice? That's grapefruit size, dude.
No, grapefruit's a little bit smaller.
Is it?
Yeah.
All
right. And, I mean, look at the seeds in there. It's crazy.
Is it grapefruity flavored?
I thought that it was grapefruit with a little more grape taste to it. Like, it still had a tartness, but the sweetness level was higher. But maybe I've just had not so great ones in the past. So that's a lot of seeds. I wonder if the one that we had before, they de-seeded the whole thing. I don't know.
Are you from America?
Yeah. Had a quick chat with the bus conductor. I call him the conductor. And I realized that when we had this before, this skin wasn't on there. And this skin is actually really bitter. So I'm just peeling it off, which is a little tedious. I didn't think I'd have to do that. And I also had to take out like a good number of seeds. So maybe this isn't like the easiest thing to eat at the stop.
Well, neither is grapefruit.
Yeah, well, we're in the same boat there. A little more tart, but this is so fresh.
Really? Is there a sweetness to it at all?
Mm-hmm.
Is it better than durian?
Yeah.
It's a bit tougher than a grapefruit, but it is definitely in the vein of grapefruit. I like it has really big like pockets on it, basically, like little, I don't know how to explain that, little sacks is what
I call it,
of.
the juice droplets.
They're really big, so they kind of like pop and explode in your mouth, and that's pretty fun. I like that texture a lot.
So we've been kind of trapped in a bus all day. We thought that we'd be getting out of the bus at around 5:30. I don't know if the weather made it so that we didn't get there quicker, it started to rain a little bit, or if I just confused the time, but I'm pretty sure he said 5:30. It's around like 6:30, maybe 7-ish now, and we're still not like within 50 kilometers of our destination, so these things happen. I know that, like I'm aware of it, but I'm starting to feel a bit imprisoned. And we just came to this roadside stop, and you just go up to like a little counter, and they've got like a couple of dishes of food, and it really feels like prison. You get your tray, they scoop stuff onto your plate, and then you take your plate to the lady at the end, and it's just starting to feel a bit prison-y. Every rest stop is exactly the same. It's like a different day at prison.
So tell me if that tastes like prison food to you.
The rice is in the Philippines, this rice is not bad. The food, I've got like a pork stew. It's good, but it's cold. I just bit into a big piece of fat.
What's your other dish?
And my other dish is humba. And I think that's just fat. It looks like just fat. I don't know what humba is. I didn't read about it anywhere. I just thought, screw it, I'll try it. And it's just fat. Wow.
So is that prison food to you?
I don't think they'd have the fat at the prison. They'd have... Well, they wouldn't have any of like these foods, I don't think. They'd be some sort of bread. Definitely be bread. But it's starting to feel a little... When are we getting off this bus? Good morning. It is around 7 o'clock, and we've gotten to Cagayan. I'm probably mispronouncing that, but Cagayan is the city that we took the bus from Dabo to, and we were hoping that we'd get a ferry from Cagayan to Camigan. We thought we'd be getting a ferry from here, but the ferry doesn't come from here. It's a 2-hour bus ride to the port city, and then you take a ferry from there, which I think takes about an hour. And we ended up meeting some people on the bus and telling them we wanted a really cheap hotel, and they dropped us off instead of taking us like fully into the heart of the city, they dropped us off at a very, very, very cheap hotel. And the cheapness definitely shows in the number of spiders that I've seen in this room. And that the bathroom is, it basically makes me want to throw up a little bit. I'm going to show you the room, and it really doesn't look bad at all. Like, when we walked in, we were like, this is fine, totally, let's do this. And then when we came back in after paying, you kind of get consumed by the mildew, and then the bugs start showing up, and then you go to take a shower, and it's just right above the toilet, and it kind of feels weird. The price for this place is 300 pesos a night. We've been paying, on average, about 750 a night. So it's half the price of what we've been paying at other places. So, one, it's definitely worth just giving it a try and seeing what it is. Because I've seen the signs for this, like this 250. It's only 12 hours. You can't stay for a very long time. It's only 12 hours, so it has kind of a manga cafe kind of feel. Without any of the, manga. So, super duper cheap, and 12 hours of sleep in a cubicle. Underneath my towel is a flat screen television. They do serve food, this menu down here, they serve food. And there's an aircon bot. So, you're comfortable, you can't really breathe, and you might be attacked by a giant spider. But that's alright. I mean, we survived. There's also a lovely trail of ants that's coming in from the air conditioning bot, but they haven't bothered us. So it's about 7 o'clock in the morning, and we have to be out of here by, we think, 8:30, but we don't want to mess with the time and have them try to overcharge us again. So we're trying to get out of here by 8 and get on the road and out of the Roach Motel. Just found out where the spider likes to hide. In my clothes.
After being in that horrible little room with all the ants, like zillions of ants and a spider and a centipede thing or something, I don't know. It was pretty gnarly. We walked out and we saw this chaos and all this smog and everything. And Katie dropped this.
I'm happy to see this.
We're still in Cagayan de Oro, and this morning we've done some administrative things. We actually finally, after being here for a week and some change, I think, we finally went and got a SIM card, and it went okay. It was a little bit hectic, and we had to talk to a lot of people. And to do that, we came to a shopping mall, and we also ended up getting some things like mouthwash and just soap and things that we've needed to get. And we found our way to a food court that they have that has three places that are serving essentially what looks like the type of things that they would have in the rest stops that we've had at bus stations and stuff. So, a plate of stuff, and then you get whatever number of plates you want with, it's all stew-type looking things, and then you get some rice and maybe a soup or something. So we found three of those places, and that's what we've got. We've got some of those things. Katie's got something scary, so look forward to that. That's coming in this minute. But what's interesting about this little food court, it's a regular mall. The mall is totally normal, like what you would think of like an American mall. And then the food court is kind of in like a garage. And you're hearing this loud voice. That's bingo. So it's a food court / bingo hall. All that's happening in the same place. Which, I mean, doesn't surprise me. It's just attached to the regular mall is a little odd. So for lunch, I got a beef stuffs. And like I said, it's just that stewy looking beef stuffs, yeah? And as usual, it's cold. The flavor is amazing. Very nice. Almost a sweetness to it. Think of like a sweet beef jerky. That's basically what this is. It's a sweet, soft beef jerky. And it's called, it literally just says beef steak on the menu, so that's what it is. And the other thing I got, have we had a soup yet in...
No.
So this is a bit new. This looks like the tree soup that I recall from Myanmar. or Vietnam, I don't know. One of the two places. We had tree soup. It's okay. It's got a little bit of a fishy flavor, and it's a little bit salty. Or peppery. Maybe both. Yeah, there's salt and pepper in there. And it, the fishy flavor is not bad. It's alright. It's a good side. Katie's dish, on the other hand, look at this. That's what she shows up with. What's going on? Are these legs? What is this? What do we got? Any ideas?
It's eggplant. I already asked.
Oh.
So I'm actually quite excited about that because I like eggplant. It just looks like they decided they'd squish the crap out of it. Like they'd squish the crap out of really, really, really big eggplant. So I'm excited about that. But this morning's been kind of tough. Getting out of the hotel room was really hard because there were ants all up in our bag and on our clothes and pretty much everywhere. We're still like brushing ants off of us. It's been 2 hours. And we noticed on my neck that I have some sort of thing going on. I don't know what that is or why it's there, or maybe I'm just frustrated and it's coming out on my neck. I don't know. And we had our SIM card situation that took forever, and I had a digestive disaster. And what I can say about that is you can still expect for me to show up with the scariest thing at the table. That's what you can expect. I can be in like the crappiest of all crappiness, and I will ask the lady, what's that weird thing? And when she said eggplant, I was like, oh my god, that's, I thought it was a fish or a frog, and if it was a frog, I was gonna get it. If it was a fish, maybe not. But since it's eggplant, I'm going with it. I wish that there was a better dipping thing, but I think I'm gonna dip into Aaron's food. But we'll just try it by itself first.
I seriously thought it was a fish when you brought it over
here. Me too.
Like maybe a fish that had evolved, like just a bit with the legs.
They tend to just give you a fork and a spoon, and you're supposed to cut like this. You use the spoon as a knife. It's obviously been cooked a little while ago, but it's really, really good.
Is the whole thing eggplant? Because, like, you've got, like, what's this guy over here?
That's the bottom of another eggplant. I think it's 3 eggplants.
That's a lot of eggplant.
But it's got a nice saltiness to it.
Is it cold?
It is cold. It's kind of like a pancake meets vegetable. I am glad I got that. It tastes really, really good. And then I also went with vegetable. There's some okra and green peas. Bit of a boring sauce, but just a crap ton of vegetables, which is fine with me. Alright, ready to eat and relax for a moment and probably flick off a few ants. You can see both of us.
Yeah, that's okay.
At the lens. We've gotten on a bus, we're going to Baliwan, and there's going to be a ferry there to go to Camiguin. And we're going to say Camiguin like Middle America, alright? We're going to Camiguin! Yeah. Camiguin's a beautiful island, but it's going to take us at least like 3 hours to get there. So we're chilling on a bus, and a guy came on and he's starting to show off these little pies. They're called buko pie, and they're supposed to be coconut and condensed milk inside. And I like all of that, mostly.
My dude just jumped onto the moving bus and was like selling them, and then he's gonna get to the end in like his little area and get off, and then get on another bus and go back the other way, and he's got like a stack of boxes of these things with him. Pretty smart. And it looked like he gave the driver a couple of them, and maybe that's how he pays for his like get allowed to be on the bus. How is it?
Almost heartier than it is sweet. Like it has kind of a chicken pot pie feel than it has a pie feel.
It's warm, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like is it warm from an oven or warm because it's been sitting in a box in the sun?
I don't know. But I think I see a little bit of cinnamon and definitely the coconut. I would say it's not not as stunning as I thought it was going to be, but it's still a very delicious treat. And it was delivered to the bus. I didn't have to move. I think today, I don't want to speak too soon, but I think today might be the most disappointing day of the trip. We woke up, you already know about the waking up, and you already know about, well, my neck looks better, maybe?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay, neck's doing better. The digestive disasters have kind of just not worked out very well. Eric got targeted recently, and then I had a little bit of targeting later. Eric's targeting was in the middle of a bus ride. And he hopped off, and I expected the bus just to roll on. And Eric went into some, like, restaurant, and...
restaurant?
Yeah, some restaurant. They were really nice. And he was in there for, like, 10 minutes, and the bus driver was outside just honking, like, it's time to go! And I'm just standing there, the middleman, like, just here, looking like an idiot. And Eric was having an awful time, but... we managed to get back on the bus. They didn't leave us. I cannot even believe that. It was like 10 minutes. I can't believe the bus just sat there. And I'm sure everybody on the bus was like, what? What are you doing? So that was a little embarrassing, but it was normal. And
this bathroom, if you've ever seen Train Spotting, that bathroom would be quite a step up from what I coped with today. Let's put it that way.
Sexy. Then we got back on the bus and we only had about 20 more kilometers to do to get to the port city that we're standing at right now. We're still standing at the port city, not floating in the sea, because they have stalled all the boats. There is another typhoon coming through the Philippines. We are fighting typhoons right now, and this one is supposed to be going to Davao, which we have left. And we've come north of, but the storm is supposed to go directly over that. And people are moving, so I'm like staring at them like, are you getting on a boat? Are you getting on a boat?
There's no boat here.
No boat. So there's no boats. And we're just standing
here. We're trying to get to this island right here. And then they have canceled the boats because of a typhoon that's quite a ways away and it's barely windy. So...
yeah. Are you getting on a boat? We're not getting on a boat. I know that you can't hear this right now, but in the background, someone's doing some terrible karaoke that's going, and hurt you, never gonna break you up, never gonna let you down. We're getting Rickrolled pretty hard right now. This is the harshest Rickroll of them all.
Is this the best part of the day or the worst part of the day?
The music stopped, so now it's the worst part of the day.
Well, it's now 5 o'clock, and the last ferry is usually going to leave at 5:30. Some people came out and made an announcement to everybody here, and they were just basically like, the Coast Guard is like saying that you can't go, which is bizarre because it's pretty calm out there. Like, it's a tiny bit windy, but like, there's even like fishermen and like little dinghy boats like dicking around out there in the water. So I don't know. Like, it seems like the people that are running the ferry are also a little confused as to why that the boats have been canceled this early. Like, I can understand, like, if a big storm is coming, like, once the storm is here, of course you want to cancel it, but it's only about an hour or less across to the other islands, so they should be able to tell that an hour ahead there isn't any bad weather. So, it's a little bit bizarre. Like, we've been here for over an hour now, and the weather hasn't gotten any worse. So, I don't know, maybe they're just being overly cautious. Maybe this ferry is really ghetto, I don't know. Maybe they're really worried about it, like a little wave or something is gonna break it into a bunch of pieces. Who knows? But we aren't really clear what we're gonna do right now.
We're gonna get a chubby.
Katie got some chubbies, and now we're just sort of chilling with the chubbies. The issue being that if the storm does come and we're still where we're sitting, we're supposed to get like 30 mile an hour winds with rain, and we're just outside. So what happens next? This should be interesting. All right, so we are on a bus going back to where we started this morning. So we've just gone in a loop. And
I like the bus.
Yeah, the bus is a lot of fun. It wasn't really fun earlier. I feel better now though, so I think I'm okay. So we're going to go back, and our goal at this point now, so tomorrow it's supposed to just rain on that island, it's supposed to rain here, it's supposed to rain everywhere. So, like, if we're going to be stranded somewhere, we should be stranded somewhere where there's a movie theater nearby, because Star Wars comes out tomorrow. So maybe we'll get lucky and we'll just turn this into a Star Wars day. Does that sound all right?
Yeah.
And I'm, after my gastrointestinal issues earlier, I'm looking forward to just something like pizza or something would be really nice. Just some bread and some tomato sauce sounds amazing right now, rather than whatever they had in the little town we were in, which you could call it a town, or you could just call it a karaoke parlor. Like, I'm not quite sure, but it looks like it's just going to turn into a rather sketchy outpost. I'm happy to be on the way back to this other little town, which honestly isn't the greatest place in the world, but maybe Star Wars.
Yeah.
As I sit here and ponder the reason that the weather was completely calm, but there were no boats running, I think I may have struck upon maybe what they're thinking. Maybe they're trying to stop people from going to the island, because that just puts more people on the island, and they're concerned that they may have to evacuate the island, and then obviously more people just creates more problems. So when they see a big storm coming, they just limit the number of people that are able to even get there, regardless of what the weather is like. So maybe I've nailed that down, I'm not sure.
Mo people, mo problems.
Mo people, mo problems.
Yeah, we were some of those mo people.
Yeah. When you're traveling, especially in countries with like a weak infrastructure, you end up stuck places, like just stranded. We were trying to get out of the city and we can't get out, and I don't think we're gonna be able to get out tomorrow either. So we're gonna go see if we can get a like the nicest hotel in town. Like, fuck it, let's just go see if we can figure out how much it is, and if it's even remotely affordable, we're gonna do it, I think, because right now I could use a warm shower.
Swanky is all I got to say about this place. It's got swank out the yin yang. It is very nice. There are chandeliers. There's a Christmas tree that looks like it's made out of like G-strings. And there's definitely like crystals hanging from the ceiling. I'm not lying. And there's like a really cool staircase. We haven't even been in our room, but this is what the lobby looks like. But we had a very, very weird, Eric says it was funny. I thought it was awkward. Situation. So I went to booking.com because that's where I book basically all the places that we end up staying at when we do book ahead, which is like 50% of the time. So I went to booking.com and they told us that we could get this room for 5,900 pesos, okay, for two nights. And I was like, wow, that's a really good price for the best hotel in town. I'm not sure exactly how many dollars that is off the top of my head, but it's a good price. We came into the hotel and the lady asked if we had a reservation. I told her that we did not have a reservation, and she showed us the list of the prices for the hotel. This was the list of the prices. One night in the same room that I had looked up as well was 55. So it was almost, they were telling me, you can only get one night for the price that you saw on the internet. She didn't know I had looked at the internet at this point. So I just flat out told her, I was like, on booking.com, I can book it right now for 59 for two nights. Can you just hook me up with that and we can take the bots out of this? And she was like, well, that doesn't include tax. And so I kept pushing through with the order on booking.com and it was like final price, and she was like, it doesn't include tax. And I was like, but even if it didn't include tax, you're still trying to charge like almost 3/4 of a night more for the price that I'm seeing on the paper.
I mean, you weren't arguing with her. It was
no arguing at all. It was just straightforward, like, I don't want to have to go through my bot. I just want us to make this deal here and then whatever. So in the end, we sat there. Sorry, I'm looking off. There's lots of people. We sat there, went through the whole registration thing on booking.com. All my information's in there, so it was like three clicks. And then I was like, so can we check in? And it was all set up, and it was the price that I had paid. And now she had to call some person like in another building in a dungeon that does the booking.com. So the booking.com troll got called, and they're now verifying our reservation and maybe we'll get a room.
So it was $59 you paid, right?
Yeah, it was $59.
And they were asking $11,000 for the same night.
Yeah, for the same 2-night stay at this hotel, they wanted $11,000, but we only paid $59. Thank you, Booking.com. This is wonderful.
So the booking troll showed up, and now the room that we booked on Booking.com isn't available, even though it was offered to us before we told the girl we had Booking.com. She told us they have that room for 2 nights. So we booked it on Booking.com instantly, and now it's not available. So they're trying to push us into a higher level room, which is a significant amount more money. So this place is a little shady.
It's not a significant amount more money. There is more money that they're asking for the room, but they're also showing us that, and Booking.com, you're hurting me here. Booking.com sometimes doesn't include the taxes, and you sometimes have to pay them directly to the hotel. In this case, the taxes are almost 1,500 pesos. So that's a significant amount of money, more than what you expect to be paying. And I didn't think that in no other situation with Booking.com have I had to pay more than what it said on their website. So at this point, it's just kind of like a slap in the face. Like,
I still don't trust the hotel. Like, she told us that we have that room, and now all of a sudden we got it cheaper and they don't have it. It's really fishy. Katie's over using her charm to see what she can get taken care of, like, see if we can figure out a way to, like, negotiate with this guy. Like, what is this? Like, is this what you expect at, like, a crappy hotel? Not, like, some, like, really, really nice hotel that's trying to, like, be all, like, uppity-uppity? Like, you gotta go over and negotiate with a dude? What is this? This is ridiculous. But to add a little bit of, like, power to my theory, on Booking.com, you can still book this room that they say they don't have. Like, it's still available. So, like, somebody either needs to update their website or, like something's got to happen here. I really do think we're being swindled here. But maybe I am jumping to conclusions. I do that sometimes. Let's see what happened.
Miraculously, they had a cancellation.
I told you, man.
Oh, man, you should have recorded me. I was like a badass up there. I was stern. And I'm not normally stern. But he was like, you know, we just don't have that room for tomorrow. And I was like, bled out. You're still advertising those rooms for tomorrow. It's not my problem. You've created this problem, not me.
So what happened?
And he ended up going back and talking to some guy for like 10 minutes. And I talked to the girls at the front desk and found out that Star Wars is playing tomorrow at Cinema 2 and 3 around 12 o'clock and after. But yeah, so everything seems pretty good and we'll be getting our room. He says he's going to go and straighten things out, so we're just going to sit here some more.
Do we have to pay more or anything?
We will have to pay the taxes that even the email
said.
And I told him that's fine. I just didn't read the fine print, but I'm not going to pay for
it. It's still cheaper than what they advertised by a significant margin.
Yeah, significant. We're going to do an unveiling of our hotel room. More things happened. Maybe we'll explain them. Maybe we won't, because at this point, we're kind of done with the bullshit. So we're just gonna do the unveiling of the beautiful room. Let's go.
Card for power, bro.
Card for power. Anyway? Anyway? Are you happy anyway?
Okay. Ooh. Hey, that's not too bad. That was my cell phone. Hey, look at this. We've got a wicked view of this kind of
funky town.
Yeah, funky town. We'll call it funky.
We haven't explained, like, people call this the armpit of this island. It's just the armpit. I kind of understood it.
Now, those aren't our words exactly. Those were what other people thought. We were like, oh, we're going to go to the city. And they all gasped. Why would you go there? So I'm so sorry if you're from this town and you love it. Like, we really don't truly know it. But that's what other people are telling us this place is like. But, yeah, the room is pretty nice. It's like a standard Western hotel room.
What, you got your shoes on?
I do. Oh man, I am so sorry, world. I do have my shoes on. Let's check out that bathroom, man. That's what I'm most interested in. Is this the best toilet I've seen today? It can't be the worst, I promise you.
Oh, let me see that toilet.
Oh, look at that. He has his own towel.
Look, there's a toilet seat. Oh, the shower.
It's got one of those rain things.
Dude, it's got two shower heads.
Yeah, look at this action. We got one, two.
Wow, now.
There's two, look at, there's two towels. There's four towels. There's five towels.
Last night.
Six,
oh
seven
my God,
towels.
Oh my God. Okay, so last night we rented this room. We rented this room and we went inside. They had a sheet on the bed, a sheet for sleeping under, and one towel. This was a double bed. There were two pillows. Count them, two pillows, but only one towel. So I went out and I was like, okay, it's gotta be a mistake. So I asked the lady, I was like, am I in that?
Yeah, you're in it.
I asked the lady, I was like, can we get another towel? And she was like, that's gonna be 20 more pesos. And I was like, seriously?
That's like twice the price of the place.
I should have explained the situation with the two towels, or with the two pillows. We have two pillows. You know there are two heads in that room. But this one towel, how did we were like, washing like this.
This is a better shot of that. Do that again. What is it like?
You gotta make sure that you got the towel. Oh, man.
So the rest of what happened downstairs is it was supposed to be 7,200 pesos for two nights, which, let me clarify, that's a lot of money. It's like $150 or something.
Yeah, it's like
$150. So like,
that's Japan prices.
Yeah, this
for
is expensive. This is expensive, right? But, you know, because we know we're going to kind of be stuck here, we decided, you know, whatever, we'll do it. So we told them it's 7,200 and blah, 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 and everything was good and PG. And then she was like, I need to charge you 8,000. And we're like, wait, what? Why? So then we had to stand there for like 15 minutes while the manager came out and then did the math and was like, see, it's only 7,200. And we were like, well, why is she asking for 8,000? Which is like $16 more. And he was just like, oh, it's just a problem with the system. We'll fix it. And I'm just like, okay. And I was like, he's like, don't worry about it. When you leave, it'll be fine. And I was like, okay. So he was like, you know, thank you. And I was like, thank you. And he walked away. And I went to the lady that worked there, who at this point hates us because like this whole thing is just retarded. So I looked at her and I was like, can I have a receipt? And this was a problem, kind of. Like, she didn't get shitty with me, but she obviously wasn't happy about it. And then she punched on her keyboard for a few minutes and gave me a receipt to say 7,200. But every corner I had, like, I just don't, they're very friendly and very nice people, but I don't trust the hotel at all. Like, it just seems like they're just, it just seems real sketchy. Like, they're just trying to pull one over on you the entire time. And the other hotel that we stayed in last night was super, super cheap, and they didn't try pulling anything over on us except for, you know, one towel
lots
and the bugs.
Lots of legs.
Yeah, legs.
Got my robe on. I'm ready.
What do you mean?
Luxury.
What's legs? What are you talking about? You talking about all the legs
of
the bugs?
I'm talking about all the legs of the bugs that were all over my face and probably have caused whatever the crap has happened in my neck. And how many ants I've been carrying around? The freaking ant colony that's in my backpack right now.
Just 10 minutes ago, I flicked an ant off my arm and it started climbing all over me. We brought those into the hotel.
I've just been dancing around the room while Eric is in the shower, and I'm shooting this because I think he'll laugh later on when he sees it, because he won't know that it has happened until like a month from now, probably. But anyways, I've been counting the number of pillows on the bed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think we have an insufficient number of towels. There are going to be 6 people sleeping in these beds. We need 6 towels.
I found this pizza place. Remember earlier I said I wanted pizza? Well, I was thinking I was kind of wussing out and not getting something Filipino, but what we did is we found a Filipino pizza place. I asked the dude just a minute ago if this was the only, like, country that it was in. He said it was. So, like, by dumb luck, we managed to stumble into that. And it's a really cool place. It's like, it's a lot like, I'm going to say it wrong, I'm sorry, world. Chipotle. How do you say it for real? Do you know, Katie? Chipotle? Chipotle?
It's Chipotle to me.
Chipotle? Yeah. I think we're saying it wrong. I don't know. I'm trying to think of how you say it in Japanese.
Chipotle.
Yeah, Chipotle.
That was terrible.
Something like that. Anyway, so we've been into Pizza Republic. And it's a lot like Chipotle or like Subway in America, where you would have like a line and you would get to pick whatever you want to put onto your sandwich or burrito. But in this case, it's a pizza. And it's a flat cost. Like, it costs, how much was it?
$2.45.
Like, $2.45 for a 10-inch pizza. And you can put as much on it as you could. He said only restricted by the thickness. Because then they can't fit it into the oven. And it's,
pretty awesome. So they have some things on the menu that are like the Hawaiian pizza or like the Meat Lovers pizza type things. Like you can select from those and then add more. So I started with a Hawaiian pizza and lao. So a Hawaiian pizza, as usual, will be pineapple and ham and cheese and sauce, and that's basically it. So I had them actually put caramelized onions, barbecue sauce, and a peppered ham of some sort on here as well. So let's see if this stacks up to my American taste buds, or if it even stacks up to, we found this amazing place in Tokyo. I don't know if it's gonna be even that good, we'll see. Oh my God. So Katie doesn't like pineapple on pizza. So if we order a big pizza, usually she orders it without pineapple, and I'm like, okay, no problem. And I really do like Hawaiian pizza. I haven't had that in so long. It's really good.
Man, I sound like a terrible person.
No. You ruin everything. Mostly just my pizza. It's good. It's not like Chicago style or New York style caliber of pizza, but like if you live in like Fredericksburg, Virginia and you get a pizza and you have this, you'd be like, oh, that's a pretty damn good pizza. It's legit for like not famous America, not pizza famous America. What did you do?
I got the four cheese because I really like cheese.
Now hold on a second here.
How am I going to tell the four cheeses apart?
That looks like a lot more than cheese, dude.
Yeah, it's way more than cheese. I got peppers, I got jalapenos, I got three different kinds of meat, I got artichokes, I got, I'm gonna have to eat some of it to remember what it was. I got regular onions instead of the caramelized ones because I couldn't find those. Even though Eric had told me about it, I was like, I don't know where they are, so I got the regular ones. I got a cheese sauce on top and a pesto sauce on top, and
Dig in.
Okay, my bad.
You were just saying you were hungry. And we got two 10-inch pizzas because this is like our only meal all day. He was like, a 10-inch pizza is good for two people. So we got two of them.
I should make all pizzas. This is like a rainbow in your mouth. It's really good. Oh, and I got good news. We have a fridge. So if they box it up, we take it home.
As much as I like my Hawaiian pizza, I have to admit, the Katie pizza was probably significantly better than mine. Mine, like, tingled memories in my mind, but Katie's was genuinely a very good pizza. I'm shocked at how good the cheese they had was. Like, being from Japan, like, living in Japan, cheese is at a premium, and somehow in the Philippines, they've got some serious cheese. That stuff was amazing. If you're curious, so we got the two pizzas, and we got one thing of Lipton iced tea, something else I haven't seen in ages, and the whole thing came to just under about $10. So yeah, that's not too bad. I just told Katie, if they took this building and dropped it into America, like, it would do awesome. Like, people would love this. It's very good. So, Pizza Republic people, if you're listening, go to America. Well, no, come to Japan. Then, like, once you figure out how that's gonna roll and everything, then you can worry about America. So, that's, I think, the best plan. It's morning now, and we can see outside, and check this out. It's kind of hard to see, maybe a bit, because the windows are tinted, because, you know, classy hotel. But check this out. Look at that. You can see the ocean, and you can see some ocean liners out there. We want to go on a boat, so if anybody has got, like, ocean liner access, hook us up. That would be amazing to make a video about.
One of the biggest things that people were telling us about this hotel was that they have an infinity pool. And I thought that an infinity pool meant that the water goes out to a glass edge and then is met by the ocean. So it really looks like it goes on for forever. But this one goes into a building. So I don't really feel the infinitiness, but it looks really, really cool. I'm not disappointed aside from the infinitiness, but it's really, really cool.
You getting a you getting a look at that infinity McDonald's?
Yeah. Also, I booked our tickets to see Star Wars. the Philippines. And you get to like book your seat and everything, and no one's going to the movie. So there's like probably, it's probably a 200 seater, or maybe 100, 150, I don't know. It's quite a large theater, and you're able to pre-choose your seats. And there was probably only 20 people going to the 9 o'clock showing tonight of the 2D version. Obviously we know it's in 3D, and some people may have opted to go for 3D. I couldn't see the seating for 3D, so maybe those are just packed. But the 2D, people are not very interested in that, so
To be fair, we were at a 7-Eleven last night that was right next to the movie theater, and there were some girls there, and they all had Star Wars shirts on and like homemade Yoda ears, and so maybe they were going to a midnight showing because it was quite late. So maybe there are some people here that are excited about it, but I'm kind of getting the impression it's not quite as jabbed as it is in America. So it's like, I don't know, 12:30 or something, and we are still not seeing any bad weather. It's a little bit cloudy. But the signs of this like tropical storm are like, it doesn't seem to be happening. So I'm still not sure why we couldn't go on that boat yesterday, but you know, whatever. So we spent the night in that like amazing hotel, and this morning we went down and we went swimming, and the swimming pool was pretty amazing. And then we worked our way out of the building to drop off some laundry, because laundry is like super important to us right now. So we got some laundry moving its way. We'll be able to pick that up tomorrow. And then we rolled down to the bus station to find something to eat. And I actually saw some dudes playing Chinese checkers with like Coca-Cola bottle caps on a cardboard box. It's pretty cool. And Katie found some bread at a bakery, and she's got something that looks like it's kind of interesting. I just glanced into it. It looks like a Chinese dumpling with a cheeseburger inside to me at this moment.
It does.
Is that what we're working with?
I don't know if you can see in there, but yeah, it just looks like a cheeseburger inside of a Chinese dumpling. But the dumpling's been toasted, so it was sitting in the same crate as like the dumplings would be, like the big mi gumon and stuff like that. But something interesting came with it. Take a moment and read that. My finger's not in the way.
Yeah, banana.
Catsup.
Yep, banana catsup.
Banana. So I'm just going to go straight from the source for a moment. It's got like a little mellowness to it. Definitely still ketchup and sweet ketchup on that. Like pretty sweet. But you can taste like a mellowness on the end of your tongue where the banana is.
There's banana, like, does it taste banana-y?
It doesn't taste banana-y. It's just that it's like mellowed out the flavor of.
Wild.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to get to the cheeseburger.
Yeah.
Or to the burger. All right. Here we go.
Is it good?
It's good.
Is it a meatball or is it like cheeseburger?
It's like Nikuman meatball.
Wild.
Yeah. Really, really good. I'm glad that I saw this. I had seen that they were selling these toasted, I don't know what the Filipino word for it is. It starts with an S. Saipao or something like that. And I'm just saying it terribly. But I saw that they were toasting these and I wanted to have one. So I was happy that we walked by it this morning.
In the cheeseburger bun, I didn't find cheese, but I found egg. These things are great. I'm thinking these might be better than what we get in Japan that's in bun form.
Enjoy your ride. Have fun. Look here.
You thought we'd sit in the hotel room? Asia's longest zip line! Woo!
This is kind of scary, but really fun.
Was that ending as shocking for you?
Yeah,
it was quite a shock.
It broke my nards.
Oh,
straight shot.
Watch the nards, man.
Yeah, straight shot to the nards.
I'm not sure how they classify the longest one, but we got onto another line and we're still going, so awesome!
I'm on my second flight, hoping my boys do a little bit better this time.
All right, so even though I was screaming and explaining that this was the longest zip line, we haven't actually been on it yet. It's Asia's longest, I guess, dual zip line that two people can ride at the same time. That's my understanding. It's 840 meters long, and let's go. So we're getting onto a truck. I don't really know where that truck is going, but I'm imagining it's going to go up high and we'll be coming down. I think what I read online was you're going to go to... never mind. I have no idea. We'll find out. What we've determined is that going up to this zip line, getting there is more the adventure than we had imagined. We rode on a motorbike for 17 kilometers. Just with some random dude who just waved to me as we were getting onto this really bumpy truck ride to go to wherever the we're jumping off or flying off or whatever. So it's been quite an adventure just getting here. Seriously.
What's up with that funky gear?
I look good.
You do.
I asked Eric to go to the prom with me, and he put on the official prom attire.
I've got one too. Don't worry, we're looking good. If you're gonna go to prom, you should wear the same thing, right? That's how that works.
I kind of feel like a potato.
I feel like a penguin.
You're a penguin, and I'm a potato. We found some like vegetation we've never seen before. These kind of funky little balls. They are hollow on the inside and squishy, almost like they've been inflated by something. And they got hairs. I'm gonna stop doing that now.
Like 840 meters is quite a ways. Like a kilometer is like a kilometer, and this is almost a kilometer, but not quite. That's a long way to just go down there, and I think we're rocking this Superman style.
These guys are the masters of carabiners. Eric is getting special instruction.
Okay.
Why?
Okay. All throughout your flight until you stop, no movement in your legs. Don't move your legs. Don't bend your knees.
Okay.
Keep your feet together. Keep your feet close until the end. And while going your flight, speed out. Slow down. Palm against the wind to reduce your speed. All the way. Aerodynamic.
Okay.
Yeah. But when you're reaching the end, when you get near on the bottom, when you're about to stop there, hands here.
Head down.
Chin to chest when you're about to stop there. Okay?
Okay.
Enjoy, Mom, sir.
Goodbye!
Man, that zipline thing, the 840-meter one, that's intense.
Mm.
It feels really calming and relaxing, and then you realize that you have to stop soon, and then when you stop, you just, like, you go, like, straight up when you hit the brake. The wall is basically you're hitting, the cable's wall. And your head, I mean, you're wearing a helmet, but your head slams into the cable really hard. It's really shocking. But, I'd do it again. I think I'd probably give it another go. I didn't get to see Katie at all though, because apparently I'm a fatty, so I go really fast down the hill. So they gave me these extra wing things that are supposed to slow me down, but they didn't give anybody else. And Katie thinks this is really funny that I had flippers.
That was hilarious. It was like little blow up things for the kids in the pool. It's just like, I'm okay guys, I'm slowing down.
So we've been at the zipline thing. It took us, I don't know, 2 hours to get here, do you think? Probably from the city?
With how slow the bus was going, yeah, it felt like almost 2 hours. Maybe an hour and a half. And yeah,
So we've been here for what, 20 minutes?
Yeah.
And then?
Now we're gonna go. We're worried that it's gonna start raining and then we're gonna be stuck on a motorbike having to go 17 kilometers from here to the bus in the rain. So we should probably just go.
I'm convinced it never rains in the Philippines, though. Everybody says it's gonna rain, but then it never rains.
I have felt like 4 drops of rain since I've been here. In this area, you can go on like plantation tours and factory tours for pineapple manufacturers and other sorts of like fruit manufacturers. I know Dole and Del Monte do stuff in this area. I believe that we're standing kind of in Del Monte's forest of pineapples. We're near Camp Phillips, and Camp Phillips, I think, is a Del Monte area. And we tried to do a factory tour, but I couldn't get the right contact information, so that didn't work out. But as we were traveling to the zip line, we realized, we're close to Camp Phillips. There's pineapples everywhere. So we kind of put two and two together, and we're giving ourselves our own plantation tour. Well, over here, there's some pineapples. And if you look over here, there's more pineapples. And some more pineapples here. And that's what a plantation tour is like. We are standing in the middle of the pineapple fields, and it really does seem like it goes on and on just forever and ever. Ooh, that's fun. Oh, that's fun. Okay, now, okay, still fun. Oh my goodness. It just goes. This is an infinity pineapple.
You got a good view up there?
Yeah.
I can't see much anything down here.
I just realized there's a lot of pineapples here. Oh, I want to take all of them, but you can't do that. That's just rude. Oh, this is... And I don't have to walk. This is great.
This is getting tiring for me.
Okay. Gosh, all right, getting down. Okay, so when you get off the bus coming from Cagayan, you end up in a city that doesn't have any transport that actually goes out to the adventure park. So you end up getting on someone's motorbike. We end up getting on someone's motorbike, and we were told by the bus driver, I asked how much it was to go, and he said it would be $150 per person. And then when we got there, the bus driver talked with his friend, and they said it's $150 per person. So we went down there, and we knew that it would be $300. I didn't know if that meant that it would be a return or not. I wasn't sure, but the guy... He didn't ask for any more money or for money when we got there. So we were under the assumption that it was go there and come back for $300. Like, that's almost $10. So I think that it's like, that's a pretty good price for him to ride 17 kilometers one way, sit for the 15 minutes we were there, and then come back 17 more kilometers. Gas isn't amazingly expensive, and he's fulfilling a need that there's no one else to do it. So I was okay with that price for a return trip. We came back and we got to see all these like amazing pineapple fields, and then he gets us back to the town. We stop and I paid him the money. I gave him the $300 and I watched him count it, and then he rode off with some lady. And then he ended up coming back and like explaining to us, no, it was supposed to be one way, $150 per person one way, so a total of $600. And I was just like, you've got to be kidding me. You sat there, you counted the money, everything was fine, and you come back 10 minutes later and you want more money. What? That's not the way this works. Like, we finish the transaction while we're standing there, both of us. And you ride away, you're agreeing that that is how much is going to be paid. Like, I don't know what more to say than that. And in the end, I told him, you know, I watched you count the money, and you had no problem with what was happening. And he was like, it's okay. And he just ended up leaving. But that was kind of a crappy ending to a really good experience. Like, we had a lot of fun. The guy was nice, and he took us over and didn't cause any drama.
And then he tried to get your honky bucks. He
tried to get my honky bucks.
I love jeepneys. This is like one of my favorite transportation methods that I think I've ever seen. It really reminds us a lot of these canal boats that run in Bangkok, the way that they function, how people just hop on and hop off, and it's just like kind of chaotic, and you just give people money and all that stuff like we've shown before. But these have the additional amazingness of the way they look. Every single one of them is different looking. It's like kind of like a graffiti style, like paint job that they all have, and they just sort of randomly put things onto them, and they have names, and it seems to be that they often use like an English sounding name. It's not always English, but like Mitch is this one's name. I love that. The one that just pulled up, oh, his name is not English. It's Sir Strongio. I'm not sure quite what his name is, but this is really cool. It gives this vehicle like a personality and maybe reflects the personality of the person who built it or the driver or whatever. I really just think it's amazing. And like you can see, he's got like horns and stuff all over, and it'll show how you use them. Is it'll show like the end of line and the beginning of line. So like the two places that it goes between. So if you know what's in between those places, you just like know when to jump on, and then boom, you can get to where you wanna go. I don't know, they're amazing. Look at this thing, it's incredible. Also, despite my claims that it never rains in the Philippines, it's not raining, but just a little tiny bit. I wonder if that means there's gonna be a big storm tonight. I don't know, I kinda get the feeling we might just be on the fringe of it. It's almost Star Wars time, so we have come to the mall where the Star Wars will be being, and we wanna get some food before we were going to go to the movie. So we were like, okay, let's find a Filipino fast food restaurant, like Jollibee or something, and we'll hit that up. But then we're walking around, and in this mall, like yesterday we were, this is the same mall we were in yesterday where we went to that food court. In this mall, which is otherwise completely normal, there seems to be like a yard sale happening. And
like a bake sale kind of feel.
And then like, and then at the yard sale, there's just people selling food, like, that they made at home. Okay? Like, not like restaurants, just some home food. So we were like, okay, we can't get that anywhere. Well, we probably can in this country, just walk down the street and find people just cooking stuff they cook at home. But we couldn't, I know there'll be a Jollibee down the street, but in the posh mall, is there gonna be this again? I don't know if I'll be in a posh mall anymore for the rest of the time we're here. So then we're gonna do it. So we got just a few random dishes. So I don't even know what this stuff is. It looks like Chinese food here. This looks like American Chinese food to me. And this looks like Japanese curry rice. So that's what I'm going in. That's, you know, as much as I know at this point. So I'm gonna try and get a little bit of meat here. And I don't know. It tastes like, not like curry rice. It tastes like Thanksgiving food. Like, it tastes like, it's not turkey, but it tastes like a turkey dish or something. Almost like a gravy or something. I mean, it's delightful. It's amazing. Of note, it's not hot, but it's warm.
Oh, good.
But it's not cold. So, it was in like a crock pot. Let's hit the Chinese food looking thing. And I wonder if it's going to be spicy or sweet. What's your bet?
Delicious.
Delicious?
Going not spicy, not sweet.
This one's cold. It's kind of like a sweet and sour chicken. The flavor is not overwhelmingly strong or anything. It's okay. This is definitely more my style, the curry looking thing.
That's good, because that's not the one I wanted.
The chicken, it's not bad by any means. It's just not exciting, a little bit boring. And then Katie got this thing that, this reminds me of a thing that we drank in Vietnam, where it was like black bean sweet drink stuff.
It's not that at all.
It's not
okay.
That at all.
They told me that it is sweet potato, taro, and banana. So it's very fruity. Well, not very fruity. It's very kind of wholesome with fruit.
Oh my god.
Yeah. And it's warm. It was in a crock pot. It's just delectable.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh my god. That's amazing. Yeah. Wow. Keep your eye open for more of this. This is incredible. Very good.
And then Katie also got a couple of little things that are like those things.
This is lumpia, and normally what I have seen, like, it looks like it's usually fried, but this one is fresh, and I thought it was a really cool thing to get from, like, a mom. Like, the ladies over there, they be moms, and I think that moms would be really good at this. And I'm gonna take a bite so we can look inside.
I believe she said this one had peanuts in it, right?
Mm-hmm. I think it is pork with peanuts. Lumpia usually has shrimp. Might have some tofu in there as well. But it's kind of like your traditional spring roll, but with other exciting flavors inside, like peanuts and things like that. It is really, really good. Not disappointed on that one.
And I'm wondering if that's going to be a sweet.
The empanada is one of those things where you don't know if you're getting into sweet or if you're getting into meat. And I think here it's more meat than it is sweet. So I'm going to take a bite in the back end.
It's like stew stuffs.
It's very wholesome, very good.
It's almost like they took this and then
put it in there. Yeah, I would definitely say that's possible. And I think here in the Philippines, they tend to do more meat-based empanadas than sweet empanadas, but I could be wrong about that. But yeah, awesome.
Can you taste that coffee and just tell me if it's normal coffee?
Did it come out of a machine?
No, she made it with a packet and then she put something inside of it, but I couldn't tell what it was.
Yeah, it definitely tastes like a packet. So, yeah, it's just your normal
coffee.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
Oh, time to eat.
Katie's got her dress on. She is ready for Star Wars. And I'm smuggling in some nips.
Don't call me nips.
No, not you. Nips.
No one cares about Star Wars in the Philippines.
It is opening night.
Opening night. And we are at the 6 o'clock show, so maybe that means something. But 9 o'clock didn't look much fuller.
Can I ask you a question? What'd you bring in with you?
Popcorn, coffee.
Yeah, this. Where'd you get this?
7-Eleven.
How'd you get it in here?
In my bag.
Like Kramer. Let me know by the time you're watching this, the rate I edit, the Star Wars movie will probably be on Netflix. I'm gonna tell Katie no spoilers. What'd you think?
I like R2 Wilson. He's awesome, very funny. And it's really hard to do without spoilers. Dang, but oh. The guy behind the mask, I am so impressed they got him to do that. I love that guy. Wow.
You're impressed they could talk him into doing Star Wars.
No. I'm not impressed that they talked him into it. I'm impressed that he was a focus of them, that they chose him. I watch him in other things. I don't know if he is a spoiler, so I can't say any more about he. But awesome. What about you?
It's really good. I would see it again. I would see it again tomorrow.
Yeah.
It was really, really good, right?
There's a showing at 9.
Yeah, wow. Like, after the 3 other movies, did you ever even see the 3 that they made in the 90s?
Yeah, I did.
Like, those were pretty awful. This was a big step up.
It was a definite big step up.
That's our Star Wars review. We shouldn't do movie reviews. We're not good at this.
No.
The guy with the mask and stuff.
Well, I just don't want to give any spoilers away. I usually say that we're sunny weather girls because we traveled for 14 months and I think we were caught up in one storm during those 14 months. And today, we're not sunny weather girls. We're flooded street girls. It's not looking good outside. We've just checked out of our hotel and our plan for today is just to stay dry. That's the only thing that we can try to do. We looked up movies, bunch of garbage other than Star Wars. Could go and see Star Wars again. Might go and see Star Wars again. But other than that, there's really nothing going on. Like, you can see that everybody else is trying to stay dry and it's just, it's dead. So we're gonna hang out. They're holding our bag, which is lovely. So we have freedom. We can go anywhere we want that is...
on this island.
Oh, definitely on this island and is covered. Yesterday we came to this food court and we noticed that they were playing bingo, or I guess this was the day before yesterday, I'm not sure at this point, but we've decided that we're going to play bingo with our boredom time, and our game is coming up. We've got the dauber, that's all that matters. But I went through the crazy web that is to be able to play bingo, and we've got our sheets, we've got our daubers, and we're going deaf from the I-17. Hopefully we can win some money. I don't know.
Man, you're gonna have to up your bingo game.
Yeah, we did not win. We played all the different types of bingo that they had. You go and you buy a sheet and they give you three games worth, but they have games interspersed in the middle that have different jackpots and things. So we're like buying those from people, and that was a little complicated, but we figured it out. And then there was kind of a lottery game called Circle 7 where you get a sheet and it has all of the bingo numbers. Like it has a B-I-N-G-O on across the top and then all the numbers listed. You pick seven numbers and they go through like 30 balls, and if somebody gets it, they get like this huge, if somebody gets all seven of their numbers, they get like a huge jackpot, but nobody got it. So that was a bit of a bummer. Like, I was so excited about that one, but we lost all the games. And I gave my dauber to a guy sitting next to me, and he seemed pretty happy, like, oh, got a new dauber, awesome. But now we're having our anti-victory hot dog.
We got a hot dog here from 7-Eleven. And the reason I got this is because there's a lot of people coming in here and getting this hot dog. Like, it seems like half the people are getting a hot dog and half the people are getting like a soft serve ice cream. And I figured, why not hot dog? And they gave me ketchup, and it's tomato ketchup, not banana ketchup. And they also gave me something called Manhattan dressing. And I don't even have a guess what's gonna happen with Manhattan dressing. So
I can hold the hot dog as well.
Do with my hot dog, man.
This hand will go unused.
All right. So I'm going to put a little bit, I guess, on here and see what happens. Maybe it's just mayonnaise. I have no idea.
It's yellow.
It's like a relishy mayonnaise, maybe? It's a sweet mayonnaise. Yeah, it tastes relishy. I'm just going to screw it. I'll just do it. Just get down on that Manhattan jinx.
And don't now, put it in your bag.
Yeah.
That was getting and, scary.
Ahead with this. And what was the hot dog? The hot dog was
29.
No. The flavor. It was like spicy.
Spicy Hungarian.
Spicy Hungarian. And they had a bunch of different ones. They had like cheese and like different kinds of cheese filled ones, like a chicken cheese and a regular hot dog cheese and whatever.
Yeah, there were like eight different choices that you could make in the hot dog game in there.
Thinking about this, maybe I shouldn't have hit the spicy Hungarian with the ketchup. That seems like maybe I should have just gone in dry. I don't know. My hot dog physics aren't on point, man. Pretty good hot dog. It's not very spicy. So, okay, it's getting spicier. Like in my throat, it's definitely a little bit, got a little bit of kick.
The hype lives up.
I can see why people are coming in here and getting these. 29 kroners is like what? $1.10 or something like that, right?
No, it's close to like 60 cents.
Oh, 60 cents? For 60
70 cents?
Cents? That's not bad. That's a good deal. And the hot dogs are being like kept warm in like that hot dog box they have. And they also have the buns in there, and it makes the buns look soggy, but they're not soggy. It's actually nice, like a nice texture and everything. Good job. Good job, 7-Eleven. Making good dogs.
So we are still in Cagayan, and this is, man, this is our fourth night that we're gonna stay here.
Third hotel,
fourth night. And so the first night was a horrible little like place with bugs, and the second place was like really ritzy and everything. And now we're in a place that sort of falls in the middle, maybe closer to the bug hotel, to be honest with you. The good news though is that the rain looks like it's stopping, and you checked the weather and it said that the storm like alert is finished, right?
Yeah, the alert is finished.
So maybe we'll actually make it over to the island that we've been trying to get to now for 2 or 3 days. Gosh, I just can't, I'm just thinking about it. I can't think, time is kind of weird, so it's like it's weird to think that it's been that long. So maybe we'll get there tomorrow. We're gonna give it another go. But I thought I'd show you the, the hotel room that we're in now. And we have all the lights on that we possibly could have on, okay? So I'm sorry if it's a little bit on the dark side, but...
Can you see me?
Yeah, well, you're just sort of like this, like, apparition or something. Is that the right word?
Yeah.
Like a ghost or something just, like, floating there. And, like, so this light behind Katie, I tried to turn it on and it electrocuted me a couple times. So we stopped trying to turn it on. So, we don't think there's bugs, but...
We wouldn't be able to see them if there were.
Yeah. And you did see a couple over here. Like, a couple of ants.
Yeah.
Which is a big improvement over the many, many ants that we had before.
Yeah.
And let me show the bathroom. So, the toilet is running perpetually. And the man tried to fix it, but he just gave up and left. Kind of like what happened when we asked what the Wi-Fi password was and they couldn't figure it out. But check this out. This is the shower. We have a problem. One night, no big deal.
Alright, so you've seen the hotel room and we've just been outside. We did walk through the neighborhood during the daytime, but the nighttime's got a definite different kind of feel. It felt seedy when we came here during the daytime, but at nighttime, it feels like Biff Tannen's Hill Valley. Like, it just feels like evil has kind of taken over, and it's really, really seedy outside. A lot of people begging, a lot of people just kind of selling stolen goods, and... It's just not a safe place. Like Eric says, like we should probably go directly back to our hotel room. I don't think that our safety is going to be a problem. I don't think anybody's going to hurt us. I just feel like it's going to be a very annoying place to be for a foreigner. A lot of people are going to come up to us to beg, and a lot of people are going to hoot and holler at us, and it's not going to be an enjoyable experience, and there's really nothing to see in the area that makes it worth being out. But having said all that about the area, just outside of this restaurant that we're sitting in, that's what's going on. Like, there's a whole bunch of low-income people, and it's obvious. It's gritty and dirty and really rough outside. But we're sitting in a very, very, very nice restaurant. It's called Ribs and Bibs. And it feels like a Panera Bread in here. It really, really just feels like a bread bowl is gonna show up. And then some kid's gonna come from outside and start banging on the window and crying. And it's just gonna be very, very awkward when these two worlds meet each other. I can't believe the people are doing, like, the kids that were outside begging, I can't believe they're not just sitting outside of this restaurant waiting for people. I don't understand how these two worlds are sitting right next to each other. Right next to each other, and that they aren't colliding in some way. The some sort of distance gets created. There's some sort of barrier that we don't see that the poor people see. They see it and they don't come over here. There's a drive-thru to this place, I think. I don't understand what's going on. It's ritzy, and ritzy is too much. It's not ritzy.
Comparatively,
whoa. Like, the kids must come over here and be like, wow, what's going on in there? It's ribs is what's going on in there. I don't know how these two things are coexisting.
This iced tea is amazing. It's like this lemony, like, explosive spritz of deliciousness. I'm down on this. And this meal was like $8.50 or something. That's it for like the whole thing for two people. So I mean, again, I don't. Is this Filipino food? Probably not. But I'm not gonna go walk around in this neighborhood looking for anything authentic, because it's damn scary out there. Somebody's gonna hurt us. So, yeah, let's see about these ribs.
So we got the, what was it called? The, you can get the baby back set, but this was the mama back set or something?
Mommy back set,
mommy,
yeah.
Mommy back set, which just means that you have enough for two people. And, I can't believe that's only like $9. In Japan, I don't even want to think about what this would cost. It'd be ridiculous. And if you're eating, if you've eaten ribs in the States, you know what's in my mouth right now. It's, there's no compromise at all. They also offer like rice, and we're not big fans of the rice in the Philippines because we're from Japan and we're snobs. Well, me at least. I don't know if Katie really cares. But we offered to change the rice to a potato. And this potato stuff, what, did you see what it was? Is it something special? Or
sweet mashed potatoes.
Sweet mashed potatoes. So I'm thinking like sweet potato that they made mashed potatoes out of. Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah.
By the color and everything. It's pretty good. Yeah, if you have sweet potatoes and you want to mash them, I think it would be a pretty good thing to do for yourself.
Hey everyone, we have a Patreon page and we'd really like for you to check it out. It'll allow you to contribute to us and make these crazy adventures we've been going on continue and get even better. So we'd really love for you to follow the link and learn more about Patreon and us. Go for it. Let's adventure.